research methodology which all these researchers are following. So our postgraduate students also, they carry out certain projects in their last two semesters. So such types of sessions are very useful for their academic enrichment. There would be some of the students joining from other institutes as well, and it will benefit, surely benefit all of us. So I request Dr. Chaya Panse Madam, our principal of Maharishi Dayanand College, to speak a few words on this occasion. Over to you, Panse Madam.
Thank you, Vaishali Madam. Respected head of geology department, Dr. Vaishali Madam, our friend, Dr. Golden Kodros, and our resource person for today, Ms. Devika, who has been here to talk on a popular lecture, especially on the spiders, and all members from NWIS who are present here, our teaching faculty of the zoology department, and my dear students. As Vaishali Madam said, we always arrange popular lectures for students, and today yet there is another interesting topic which Devika Madam is going to address, and that is on spiders. Madam, on behalf of the zoology department and Maharishi Dayanand College, I welcome you to our institute. Just to tell you a little about our institute, we are a 60-year-old institute. We are situated in the heart of Mumbai city, that is in Parel. And this institution has got zoology right from its inception. And we have got classes right, even the graduate, the postgraduate, and the PhD. We specialize in marine, that is in oceanography, in the postgraduate classes. And many students have completed their PhD under the guidance of the Faculty of Zoology. Our college is NAC AIG accredited. We also have got the Best College Award in 2014. And also this year, we have been awarded Best College by an institute from Bangalore. Our students excel in sports and dramatics. We have got number of more than 35 Shiv Chhatrapati Award winners, Eklavya Award winners, Arjun Award winners, and many more. Similarly, the Marathi theater is dominated by our students, and most of the serials and the Marathi plays, our students are either working as producers, or they are working as actors or writers or music directors and so on. Madam, thank you very much for accepting our invitation. Golden sir, we are happy to have you again here, and I welcome you all on behalf of MD College to our to this program on popular lecture series. Thank you.
Thank you, madam. I would like to request Supritha Madam, Faculty of Zoology Department, to formally madam, that is today's speaker.
Thank you, ma'am. I take this great opportunity to introduce you all to Ms. Devika Muruthala Salam. I hope I have pronounced it right, madam. She is MSc Zoology from Bharatiya University and has worked in Krishi Vigyan Kendra and has analyzed soil samples for farmers over there. She is a keen bird watcher, but much more enthusiastic with respect to spider watcher, I can say. She has been documenting spiders in several habitats like forests, agriculture, wetlands, and human landscapes. She has one of her research papers on spiders accepted for publication in the Indian Journal of Forest Ecology. Presently, Madam is working at SECON with NWIS Resource Partner for Wetland as IT Officer. We welcome you, Madam. Over to you.
Thank you, Madam.
Devika, Madam. Am I audible? Devika, Madam.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Madam, we cannot see your video. Now you are there. Thank you so much for being here with our students, and we are very eager to know about the study and your observations about spiders. please go ahead with your presentation. Thank you so much.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Yes, we can see you, madam.
Ma'am, my slide is visible, ma'am.
Yes, yes, ma'am. Please go ahead.
Okay. Good afternoon, all. I'm Devika from Salim Ali Center for Ornithology and Natural History. I'm today going to talk about spider diversity, in which I will be discussing spider anatomy, spider habitat, feeding gills, hive patterns, spider types, reproduction, hunting methods, and the role of spiders is maintaining healthy ecosystem. This slide shows the spiders' introductions. Spiders are invertebrates, which belongs to the group of animals known as arachnids. If you look around your house or garden, park, you will probably uncover several different types or species of spiders. The variety of species, each with its own particular ecological requirements, makes spiders an excellent group to survey when assessing the health of habitats. Spiders are two infra orders. One is Maglomorphae and another one is Araneomorphae. Maglomorphae, this group of spiders comprising most heavy-bodied, stunt-legged spiders, including tarantulas, funnel web spiders, mouse spiders, and various families of spiders commonly called trapdoor spiders. Most species of Maglomorphae have Ma'am, my slide is visible.
Yes, yes. Madam, slide is visible and you are audible. Please continue.
Okay, ma'am. Spiders are two infra orders. Oh, one is Maglomorphae and another one is Araneomorphae. Araneomorphae spiders, they are distinguished by having a fangs that oppose each other and cross in a pitching action. Spiders is an insect. Please, anyone answer me? Okay. Spiders is not an insect. It is an arachnid. Arachnids are a separate group of animals to insects. Spiders are member of the class Arachnida. Insect class is Insecta. Yes, spider's body has two main sections, whereas that insect has a three sections. An insect body has a three main sections, the head, thorax, and abdomen. All insects have a six legs, two antennae, and bodies that are divided into a three main sections. Spiders also lack of wings and therefore cannot fly. Spiders have eight legs, whereas insects have six legs. This slide shows the spider anatomy. The main body parts of spiders, pedipalps, jaws, spinnerets. Spinnerets are used for the production of silk, a complex fiber that used to make webs, drag lines, egg sacs. The cellulae are used spiders' jaws. They are located in very front of spider's cephalothorax. Every spiders have a pair of cellulae and they are tipped with Thanks. Cells are filled with muscles and are used to hold prey while the spider injects venom. Pedipalps helps the spider sense objects that it is encounters. Some spiders also are pedipalps to save their webs and aid in prey capture and feeding. Pedipalps are used by male spiders to transfer sperm to female spider. I'm showing some different eye patterns in few families. Diniopus, first one is Diniopus, and second one Salticidae, third one Lycosidae. This slide shows the where do spiders lie. Spiders live edges of the ocean, plants, rocks, trees, caves, and over the water. Common house spiders usually spend their entire life indoors. They live in hidden spaces and undisturbed areas, like behind a bookshelf and underneath the basement of stairs. Most common places you will find spiders in your home, inside your vegetation will attract spiders both inside and outside of your home. In dark spaces in your outdoor areas. This slide shows the different kind of habitats where the spiders live. The first one is grassland, second one dry woods and pipelines also spiders live. This slide shows the different types of spider webs. The silk in a spider web is actually 5 times stronger than the strand steel. The same thickness. It is also believed that a spider web made up of strand as thick as a pencil could stop an airplane in flight. Spiders is good architectures. Spiders often replace their web every day. It is common for a spiders to eat their own webs daily to recover some of the energy used in spinning. Through incrustation and digestion, the silk proteins are thus recycled. Spiders will sit in the middle of the web because it is the spot where they can get any other spot in the web as fast as possible. They can also get a good sense of where they has been caught from the center of the web. Feeding behaviors of spiders. Spiders mostly carnivorous. They hunt and trap flies and other insects in their webs. After paralyzing its prey, some spiders may wrap it in silk, make it easier to transport back to the nest. Most spiders don't eat their whole prey. Instead, they expel digestive enzymes into the animal to liquefy it. Spiders immobilize their prey in two ways, by biting and injecting paralyzing venom and by silk swathing and dropping. Most hunting spiders simply grab and hold their prey in the pedipalps and front legs while biting it. For example, wool spiders and jumping spiders have keen eyesight. The latter stalk their prey to within 5 to 10 centimeters and then once when it moves. Many craft spiders wait for prey for flaws on a colors similar to their own. They use their legs to grasp an unsuspecting insect and then give it lethal bite. This slide shows the spider's hunting methods. The ecological guild concept has been great instrument to arachnologists, and there are different manner in which spiders foraging a common resource, prey arthropods, has led to numerous attempts to classify them into guilds. The ambushers, the spiders belongs to the family Domesidae, do not build the webs to trap their prey, but they ambush unsuspecting insect that come within contact, grasping them with their strong, spiky, covered front legs, similar to Venus flytrap plant. Ground runner spiders do not spin web silk, but they do not trap prey within their webs, as they do not construct any kind of web. Rather, they hunt and chase prey along the ground. The members of the family Ganoposidae comes under the guild. The orb weavers, these spider catch and eat the insect they trap in their webs. When an insect touches the sticky web, it gets caught. The spider quickly rushes in and starts spinning the wrapping in insect in move webbing to keep it trapped. For examples, Araneidae family, Tetrachnathidae family, and Culebridae. And foliage runners, as the name indicates, such group of spiders spend most of their time running on the foliage of the crops. For example, the member Cluburnidae and Sparacidae. The space builders construct webs, but the web has no adhesive properties. Orb web, but the irregular structure traps insect, making escape difficult. The spiders quickly envelops its prey within silk and inflicts the fatal bite. The prey may be eaten immediately or stored for later. The member of the family Pholcidae are example of this category. Most of the spiders of silk web builders, most of the spiders is family weave seed like webs, and the spiders hangs under the web above the seeds. Spiders insert scaffolding of threads. Insect fly against these strands and falls onto the web where they are caught. Spiders bite through the webs to paralyze its prey. They are transferred to draft spaces. Stalkers are hunting spider located prey by searching randomly and responding to vibrations. For example, wool spider and jumping spider. They are active hunters, often seen during the day, up, down, and walls in houses as well as in the field. They hunt small arthropods by stalking them slowly and finally jumping on them. Most of the members of Archaeopteryx and Salticidae constitute this foraging guild. Spider venom. Spider venoms are a cocktail of many chemicals. spider venom has a potential to replace opiates. Some of neurotoxins which evolved to kill or immobilize arthropods like insect by attacking their nervous system. Other are cytotoxins which help break down the tissues. So the spiders can inject and liquefy the meals. Spider copulation. Male hunting spiders rob morels of food in their silk and offer this as gift to prospective mates. Male spiders usually die soon after or even during the mating process, although some females eat the male after mating. This practice is not common. Females of some species mate only once, whereas other mate several times with the same male or mate with several different males. The long-lived female myoglobin spiders must mate repeatedly because they sell their skins once or twice a year, including the leaning of this. Sometimes males choose females who are large and better conditioned to avoid being eaten. Pheromones can be emitted both from a spider's body and from its silk. This form of chemical messaging allows for long distance or airborne or direct communication between spiders and enables them to locate a mate. Distinguishing between male and females are decided on the suitability of potential partner. Males also use the silk in another way. They are among the few species that offer wedding gifts of prey wrapped in dense layers of silk to females to eat them during copulation. This slide shows the spider's reproduction. The spider's life cycle has three stages of development: one, egg, spiderlings, and adult. Depending on the species, spiders can up to lay 3,000 eggs, usually in one or more egg sacs. In some spider species, the female dies after laying eggs. Others carry the egg sac in the cellucere or attach into the their spinnerets. Still other spiders hide their eggs in nests or attach them to the web. Spiders go through their larval stages within the egg. Spiders produce so many eggs because not all will reach maturity. When the eggs hatch, the spiderlings that emerge a miniature version of their adult versions. Depending on the spiders, the average lifespan of spiders can be up to a year or two. Most spiders will only survive for one season. Egg and egg sacs. Female spiders produce their one egg sac containing several to 1,000 eggs or several egg sacs, each with successfully fewer eggs. Females of many species die after producing the last egg sac. Others provide care for the young for some period of time. These females live 1 or at most 2 years. Females of Maglomorph spiders may live up to 25 years, and those of primitive Hyplogen spiders up to 10 years. The prospective egg sac surrounding the eggs of most spiders is made up of silk. Although a few spiders tie their eggs together with several strands of silk, most constructed elaborate sacs of numerously layer of this silk. Eggs, which often have the appearance of drop of fluid, deposition of silk pad, and then dropped and covered to so that the finished egg sac is a spherical and disc shaped. The females of many species place the egg sac on a stalk, attach into a stone, and cover with a smooth silk before aborting it. Other females guard their egg sacs or carry them either in their jaws or attached to the spinnerets. Female wool spiders carry their egg sacs attached to the spinnerets and instinctively bite the egg sac to permit the young to emerge after a certain length of has elapsed. This slide shows the spider's maturation. The young one of the species are independent when they emerge from the egg sac. After hatching, wolf spiders usually numbering 20 to 100 climb up onto the back of their mother and remain there about 10 days before disappearing. If they fall off, they climb back up again. Seeking contact with bristle-like structure that is called setae, some female spiders feed their young. When food has been sufficiently liquefied by the females, the young also feed on their mother's prey. The types of spiders are known as the tangle web spiders are often referred to as a comb webs and do not have a definable pattern of them. Look for a small funnel opening near the top of the web. Dinuoper spiders consist of stick-like elongated spiders that catch prey by stretching a web across their front legs before propelling themselves forward. The jumping spiders are the second largest family of spider, more than 6,380 species identified. The scientific name of the jumping spiders family is Salticidae. Trapdoor spiders, large burrowing myoglomorph spider. The social web spiders inhabits the semi-arid areas of the central and southern states. 10 to 100 of individuals reside in a colony. This is built with the help of leaves, twigs, prey remnants, and spiders' own exoskeletons. The colony is wrapped around with the spider silk, forming a nest-like structure with various exterior openings. Crab spiders. It looks like a crab, most found in flowers. Arb weavers. Arb weaving spiders are three-clawed builders of flat webs with sticky spiral capture stick. The building of webs is engineering feat, begun when the spider floats a line on the wind to another surface. The spider secures the line and off, and then drops another line from the center. It's producing a Y shape. The rest of the scaffolding follows with many radii of non-sticky silk being constructed before a final spiral of sticky captured silk. Many orb weavers build a new web each day. Most orb weavers tend to be active during the evening hours. They hide for the most of the day. Generally, towards evening, the spiders will consume the old web, rest for approximately 1 hour, then spin a new web in the same location. Thus, the webs of orb weavers are generally free of the accumulation of detritus common to other species, such as a black widow spiders. Next one is cellar spiders. Cellar spiders found in domestic settings. Whole family of cellar spiders hang inverted in the meshy and irregular shaped webs. These webs are constructed in dark and damp recesses, such as in caves, rocks, loose bark, and abundant mammals' burrows. In areas of human habitation, folsidae construct web in undisturbed areas in buildings such as a high corner, attics, and cellars. Hence, the common name cellar spiders. Linnet spiders, in spite of being large ambush hunters, are very speedy runners and leapers, alert and with good vision. Except when defending egg purses, many tend to fly rapidly when approached by predators or large creatures such as humans. They tend not to be very aggressive towards others of their own species, and sometimes meet casually in small groups. Archaeopteryx in general rely on keen eyesight in stalking, chasing, or ambushing prey, and also in avoiding enemies. Some members of this genus Archaeopteryx are abundant enough to be important in agriculture system as biological control agents. The next one is wolf spider. Wolf spider also called ground runners and hunting spiders. Belongs to a large and widespread group of Lycosidae family. They are named for the wolf-like habit of chasing and pouncing upon the prey. Most small to medium sized. The large has a body about 2.5 centimeters long and legs about the same length. Ant mimic spiders. Several group of spiders have evolved to look and behave like a various species of ants. This is common known as mimicry. There are also spiders that mimic other insects such as flies and wasps. Ant mimic spiders can be found anywhere ants are found. Numerous species of spiders trick beaver ants by mimicking their appearance and behavior. They steal their identity and larvae, and sometimes even kill and eat them. Why spiders are important? The Spiders play an important role in maintaining healthy ecosystem as well as consuming large number of insect pests as a prey. They have the threat of killing all insects leaving their territory. For this reason, spiders are favorable biological control agent in an agriculture ecosystem and can be successfully used to check pest population in the field. Crab spiders are good pollinators. Male crab spiders to ensure that pollen is spread when drinking a nectar from various flowers they visit while searching for a female partner to mate with. Since spiders are integral in consuming disease-carrying pests such as ticks, flies, roaches, they actually slow and spread of the disease this insect carries. Spiders eat household pests like mosquito and spider's venom can treat medical conditions. Why it is important to save the spiders? The most of important reason for conserving spider is the role they play in providing free ecosystem service, such as keeping in pest control, insect pest populations, serving as food for birds and bees, and provision of spider silks and venom. They are eco-friendly means of getting rid of insect. Spiders are bioagent and help the farmers by eating the small insect that cause harm to crops. They are found on all kind of agriculture fields. Many farmers unaware to the benefits of the spiders and insects and kill them by spraying chemicals. These are the some of the field guides available in India available on Indian spiders. This slide shows the some of the video clippings recorded during my study. This is a red ant mimic spider. It is eating lace wing. It is captured by earliest worker place at KVK. This one is Salticida family. This is Philippa spiders eat dragonflies. The size is not matter. This video also captured in human habitation. This video, Philippa spider is same spider species. Thank you. I thank Dr. C.S. Panse, principal, and Dr. Vaisali Somani, head of the department of Maharishi Dayanand College of Arts, Science and Commerce for giving me this opportunity. I also thank Dr. Godin Quadras, NVIS coordinator, for his constant support and guidance. And I grateful thank to Zulfia Begum and Mohammed Ibrahim. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Devika Madam. That was very interesting session to know so much about spiders. And I'm sure that our students have enjoyed this session. Now, on behalf of the participants, may I ask a question or two?
Yeah, sure, ma'am.
Yeah. That was really elaborate piece of information, knowing in and out about the spiders. It was really very interesting, and congratulations for your study. Can you tell us little more about your studies? How many, what was the exact number of spiders which you could record in your study? And is there any special equipment required to study the spiders?
Ma'am, I still now I have seen 105 species of spiders.
Oh, 105. That's a huge number. Yeah. So that identification is done under my.
Ma'am, I usually searching photographs, ma'am.
Okay. So you have tracked them with your camera. Was there any?
No, ma'am. Mobile cameras only. Mostly using.
Mobile camera, yeah. So students will be happy to know, because everyone is with mobile, and so if with your mobile, if you can capture so many species, then it must be really wonderful. Yeah.
So last slide, you can see the thank you slide. That is also mobile captured picture.
Is it? That's so beautiful. Yes. Yeah, very interesting. And madam, could you record these species in all the seasons, or any particular season is better for their observation?
Ma'am, all the season we can see the spiders, but some spiders can see some seasons only, ma'am.
Okay. And do you think in urban areas like Mumbai, there would be spiders in gardens or our college buildings or our houses?
Yes, ma'am. Sure, we can see the spiders house. Whole sit spiders, we can see the houses, and jumping spiders can see ground runners, and orb weavers, we can see the gardens, ma'am.
Okay, that's very interesting. So, did you carry out the study for entire 1 year, or what was the study period?
Ma'am, I study entire year. Since 2017 to still I'm searching spiders.
Okay, so probably you will add to more numbers.
Yes,
you have already crossed 100, yeah. So more will be added. And do you think that the flora or the plants which are present in that study area, do they have any influence on the spider diversity? Maybe it's just a question. You can think of it. I was related to plant. Yeah.
Once I get with the question, ma'am.
Yeah. Sorry. I think probably I was too fast. In study area where you are studying spiders, if there is a diversity of the plants, if vegetation is diverse, then will it be related, will it be influencing the spider diversity?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So that's very interesting. I request student participants, I have asked some of the questions from your side, but if any other participant would like to ask any question, You are most welcome. There are so many faculty members from different colleges of zoology department from Mumbai University. I can see Dr. Sachin Gosavi, Dr. Madhuri Taide, Dr. Patole sir from Kokan area. Thank you all the teachers for being here. And if your students have any questions, you can please type it in chat box or you can directly switch on your mic and ask the question. Yeah, anyone? Okay, so probably now we will start thinking more about spiders and Patole sir, you want to speak? You are most welcome. Please switch on your mic and you can speak.
Hello, ma'am.
Yeah.
Hello, sir.
Actually, we are preparing for the our RAR. That's why I couldn't join at the right time. So just I joined and I think I missed a good opportunity to listen about the spiders. Extremely sorry for that.
Okay.
No problem, sir. If Devika madam and Invis, they permit, we will try to put this recording on YouTube and we'll surely share for the benefit of your students if they permit us. But yes, thank you for joining. Sure. Yeah. We will propose to put the recording on YouTube and we'll support Invis sales. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
I think Devika madam, more questions will be there once students will start observing the spiders and making note of that. Anyone else from Invis?
Madam, very good presentation, very informative.
Thank you.
I have a small question, do the same species of spiders change their predation strategies according to the habitat?
Maybe, sir.
Is there any study conducted like that? If anything knows about it.
Sir, no idea. I will look.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.
Thank you, Dr. Shirish. Anybody else would like to speak? You are most welcome. Please switch on your mic and you may ask your question or give your comments. Yeah.
Ma'am, can I ask something?
Yeah. Please, Mitali, please go ahead.
Ma'am, are spiders are poisonous?
No, some spiders, all the spiders is not poisonous. Some spiders are poisonous. Like black widow spiders are poisonous too.
Okay. So, Devika madam, you had to take any special care while taking photographs or while chasing the spiders because there was a possibility that it would have been poisonous or something like that. So, could you handle all the spiders? Because for photographs, sometimes you even have to touch the spider to have a proper.
No, ma'am. Sometimes I can touch. It's not harmful.
Yeah. There is a question from one student, Anurag. He is asking, is there any economic importance of spiders?
Yeah, spiders venom is using for medical purpose, ma'am. For cancer treatment, like drug derivation.
Okay. So there might be more therapeutic options from the world of spiders. Yeah, that is possible. When we are talking about bioactive compounds, maybe spiders will prove more useful in the coming days. Yeah. So, Arag madam has answered your question. Anybody else has any question? Yeah. So, I think when we'll have more questions, madam will be. Anurag is saying, madam, if you can read, it's coming from the chat box, that is the spider silk so strong that it can even stop the aeroplane? something which probably has heard on WhatsApp groups. Yeah, madam, can you please comment on that if possible about the strength of spider silk?
Ma'am, just in the spider web size is 0.1 micron size. It is stronger than steel.
Okay. So, madam, last question from my side, if you allow. Is there any good reference book available for identification of spiders?
Ma'am, I can show the... Ma'am, previous slide is shown. This textbook, ma'am.
Okay.
These are the Indian spiders textbooks.
Okay.
Spiders of India, yeah. And field guide of to the spider genera of India. This Spiders of India books helps to species level identification. This spider genera of India books helps genus levels, ma'am. Beginner, we can use spider genera of India.
Okay. So they provide photographs also for the reference?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Or are there any e-groups like how we have Butterfly India or Indian Flora?
Ma'am, yes. Facebook groups are there, ma'am.
Okay.
Spiders are subcontinent. Like this Asian Arachnologist Society, some groups are there, ma'am.
Okay, because nowadays students are more part of all these groups, so probably they would like to know more from such groups. Yeah. So thank you so much, Devika madam. I'll proceed with the formal vote of thanks from MD College. Yeah, so if you permit for that. So thank you, that was really a wonderful session, and spiders are really very interesting creatures, and Devika madam, you have generated more interest in this field, and I'm sure that students would like to more about these creatures. Because whenever there are any topics in the syllabus, we try to invite a resource person who has actually worked in the field, so that those experiences are shared and we can have curriculum enrichment. And I must say that it was really a wonderful session. So thank you so much for sparing your valuable time and interacting with our students. Thank you, Dr. Golden Quadras, sir, Dr. Shirish Manchi, sir, and the entire team of NVIS SETCON for collaborating with Zoology Department, MD College, and enriching our students. Our experience is that SETCON is always holding our hands for all the conservation activities. So I thank the entire team of NVIS and SETCON for their continuous support. I appreciate the faculty members of zoology departments across University of Mumbai for being here and enjoying this enriching session. Thank you so much for your support. I appreciate the efforts taken by all my faculty members of zoology department, Maharshi Dayanand College, for taking continuous efforts in academic enrichment of students. I thank Dr. Chaya Panse madam, our principal madam, who is also a zoologist, and she is always there to guide and support us for all such activities. Dear participants, the feedback link for this session is posted in the chat box. So kindly take out 2 minutes and please fill and submit the feedback form. Thank you for your participation. There are requests always from student side that they want to know more about nature and wildlife. So I'm sure that zoology department will be always there with you for such enriching sessions. So thank you so much. Take care.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Yeah.
Thank you so much. Thank you, everybody.
Yeah. Thank you, Dr. Golden. Participants, please fill the feedback form. The link is available in the chat box. Thank you so much, Patole sir. Thank you, Dr. Sachin Gosavi sir, for being here. Yeah, and thank you, Madhuri Taide madam, all the teachers who are present over here, and all the students. Yeah, if you have filled and submitted the feedback form, you may leave the meeting.